A positive self-image and the way you dress are some of the key components needed to instill high self-esteem and confidence in yourself. So the Dress for Success NPO is one that aims to create a network of support for women in need by providing them with professional clothing and career development tools to help them achieve self-sufficiency. So founding member and CEO Tiara Papen joins us in studio to tell us more about the organization, and we're asking you on our socials, what would you like to know about how to get more self-sufficient? Don't forget to use the hashtag Afternoon Express with your answers. Tiara, welcome to Afternoon Express.
Thank you so much, Jeannie.
You know, I just think it's so fitting that your name is Tiara, because basically what your business is to adjust women's invisible crowns.
Absolutely.
So, I mean, well done on the
that's
work that you
hashtag,
do.
That's my hashtag, wear your Tiara.
Yeah, that's very, very smart. So tell me a little bit about your NPO and how it started.
Jeannie, so in my background is in human resources. I've been in HR for about 25 years. And so I really understood the challenges that women face when they were trying to enter the workforce. And having worked in HR, you almost have the power of giving someone an opportunity, giving someone a job, and seeing how their entire life changes, right? In 2010, I, by pure chance, was Googling, came across it. Very passionate about supporting young people. And I thought, you know what, we need this in South Africa. And so I did my first application, although it was declined. After 7 years of trying, second application later, late 2017, it was finally approved.
Amazing.
So Dress for Success Cape Town is an affiliate of an international NPO who has its head office in New York. Today, in 32 countries around the world, there are 150 of us.
Okay.
So it's a global movement of change. And so for myself, particularly bringing this NPO into South Africa and more importantly into the Western Cape, it has been an absolute honor. To be able to do that.
And I just think there is such a dire need for it. Like, imagine when you're going for a meeting or an interview, how you're dressed is such a big part of it. So how are you able to find these girls, and how are you able to dress them?
So that's a very good question. We work with referral partners, Jeannie. Okay. So on the one hand, we ask women like you and I to, you know, do a closet clean out. Everyone has something in their cupboard that's too big or too small. We don't know why we bought it in the first place. It's the wrong color. It's probably on sale, you know. to do a closet clean out and donate clothing to us. And so because we collect free clothing from people, there's got to be a reason behind how we give out that clothing.
So how do the girls cut it?
Exactly.
How do you choose who gets an outfit or not?
We don't. We work with women, you know, all ages, mainly high schoolers, fresh out of high school, or they can be an elderly woman who's maybe got a divorce, husband's passed away, they need to get back into the workforce for whatever reason. They come to us referred by referral partners. So our referral partners are schools, colleges, universities, even prison nonprofits who are working with rehabilitated women, church, community groups, and other nonprofits who work with women. And so they sign up as a referral partner to us, and they then refer the women to us. So it's an entire cycle of support.
I can just imagine the look on some of these girls' faces when they suited up in their new corporate wear. I think you're basically like a fairy godmother to them, to like a Cinderella going to the ball. Tell me about some of the success stories that you've had so far.
Gosh, there's so many, Jeannie, but one in particular last year, we worked with Kwela Tourism, and they referred 10 ladies to us that had finished a hospitality learnership. And on the very last day, I had a girl by the name of Pamela come through to our offices. And at first I thought, are you in the right place? Dressed up as a guy, baggy pants, big chunky shoes, shirt, jacket, you know, one of these beanies. And, you know, she said to me, well, I'm Pamela, I've been referred here, you know, to Tiara. She came in, we started chatting. And we actually, the first time she put a dress on was with us.
The first time in her life?
In her entire life.
That must have been so moving.
Absolutely. I started unpacking the story with her, and we realized that the reason she dressed the way she did was because, there she is.
That is such an outstanding makeover. That is
what
beautiful.
A transformation, right? She
Why
said
was she dressed like a boy before?
To protect herself.
Oh,
she
wow.
didn't want to get raped. She didn't want to get assaulted. She didn't want anyone to know she was a woman. You know, I got home and I cried.
Actually.
I mean, it's scary that to understand
so
what these women go through. And I mean, can you imagine in today's world that a piece of clothing can be such a barrier to a woman finding a job, taking one step closer to be employed, and breaking that cycle of poverty?
You know, they say never judge a book by a cover, but how many times does that happen?
We do.
Thank you for the work that you do, and all of your details will be on our website, just in case any of you out there at home have got some corporate wear that you would love to donate. It really is for such an outstanding cause. So we're asking you a social media question. Pali, you've got this.
I do have it, Jeannie. Thank you so much. So we've asked you on social media, what would you like to know about how to get yourself self-sufficient? And we've got one of our incredible viewers, Lazarus, here saying, is it appropriate to wear jeans to an interview? Is it, Tiara?
Yeah. How do you know what to wear to, like, what is defined as corporate wear nowadays? Can you wear jeans?
The world's changing. Yeah. So we get a lot of, you know, we get women that are going to your Investec type interview who want to be fully suited. And then there are other people that are going into a more smart, casual work environment. Yeah. So, you know, jeans and something, you know, really a beautiful shirt and a jacket actually works really well for some interviews. Amazing. So is it appropriate? At times, yes.
Yeah, I think if they're nice and clean. Thank you very much, Lazarus, for your question or comment.